My name is Rebecca Harmon. I am a nursing student enrolled in the BSN program at the College of Nursing at the University of Colorado Anschutz Medical Campus. After high school, I wanted to become a part of a missions organization. I did a three-month internship in Guatemala, and what I did was, in one of the weeks, we did a medical week. And so I was the medical interpreter because I was the only one on the team that spoke Spanish. So in one of the consults, I interpreted for a provider. In this certain consult, it was a Quechi Mayan patient. And so she, you know, she had her two kids here and a baby, and she was multitasking, and we were trying to figure out what exactly she needed. And so she would say, "Me duele la cabeza," and I would tell the provider, "Her head hurts." "Where does it hurt?" "Donde te duele?" "Me duele aquí." "It hurts here." And it was just like an on and on process. And I thought, oh man, how much easier would it be for me to just give this consult on my own, in her own language, with the ability to just do it right on the spot without it taking so long. And so I realized that it would be awesome for me to be a part of the medical community of being a native Spanish speaker. I work at a safe house for girls that are recovered from sex trafficking. And so one time we got this girl that was recovered by the FBI. And we try to get to know these girls and kind of develop plans for them. And so this certain African-American girl came up to me and said, "You know, Rebecca, I heard you're in nursing school. Tell me all about that. I'm thinking I wanna get into nursing." And so this was like super exciting for me because, you know, I try to get anyone into nursing that has any sort of interest in it. And so that same day, actually, she went to sleep late because we were researching and different things that she could get into. We developed a plan where she would sign up to community college. I told her exactly the classes she would have to take. I helped her kind of develop a plan as soon as she got home. And so this really helped her because she doesn't have parents that were able to help her with college planning or anything like that. And so her eyes were just wide open because it was just so clear to her how easy it was to, okay, after this, you do these classes and maybe take a CNA class so you could work at a hospital and get experience. And here are the list of schools around your area that you could get into and apply to. And so it was really cool to be a part of that. One of the important things is finding a mentor, because sometimes in a lot of Hispanic families, you don't have that big push to go to college. And so I think there's so many mentoring programs here, specifically for Hispanic students. And so I think finding a good mentor to push you through applying for nursing school and getting through the ugly process of going through all the prerequisites, and not giving up at the prerequisites, because those are pretty difficult. I mean, you have microbiology, you have different, like, tons of science classes, and one can feel so overwhelmed, but it's good to remember that we are needed, you know, a Spanish speaking or even not Spanish speaking, it could be any multicultural background is so needed in our community now. I plan on getting a couple years experience, but I really want to be able to do the Doctorate of Nursing Practice program at CU specifically. Depending on what exactly I want to hone in on, I'll definitely want to get my doctorate in nursing practice.